It's estimated that of the 5 million people currently in the United States diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease, approximately two-thirds of them are female. So, for example, young females tend to actually have protection against those factors that contribute to Alzheimer's disease, things like oxygen radicals, things like amyloid burden in the brain. But as women become older, they actually lose that protection. So the thinking at the moment is that there may be certain estrogenic compounds that are important in providing protection against the toxicities leading to Alzheimer's disease. The risk factors for Alzheimer's disease are acknowledged to be primarily age as the number one risk factor. Two is metabolic status, and by that I mean blood pressure, cholesterol, diabetes, triglycerides, that these contribute in making the brain more vulnerable to the effects of age and to the onset of symptoms of Alzheimer's disease. There are also some genetic susceptibilities that are starting to be recognized. There's one called ApoE, or apolipoprotein E. And those of us who have one or two copies of that allele, particularly ApoE4 allele, seem to be more vulnerable to Alzheimer's disease as well. So the numbers that we're hearing about, 5 million at the moment, and really up to about 25 million around the world, are expected to increase exponentially in the next 20 to 30 years. The implications for what is the now the tremendous increase in Alzheimer's disease cases is to do early screening in as widespread a fashion as possible. And this is really falls within the responsibility of primary care physicians and other primary care providers to do mental status screening as part of regular checkups for healthcare, whether it be on a yearly or every other year basis. Each person's a little different in terms of their cognitive abilities, but their primary care provider is in a position to determine that as they are getting a little bit older and are still healthy and independent. And with that baseline in mind, they will be able to identify the earliest symptoms of Alzheimer's disease as possible. And it's at that very early stage that we think we're going to have more and more success in slowing the disease symptoms significantly. There are several new treatments in phase 3 trials that, if successful, will go on for FDA approval and for actual application. These are things such as intranasal insulin, anti-amyloid medications that clear out this excessive protein buildup in the brain that we think is one of the hallmarks of Alzheimer's disease. So there's great excitement in the field at the moment that we'll be able to successfully treat these very early stages of the disease.